Abstractionism. And the 20th century really, in some respects, is this argument between the figuration artists and the abstractionists. So these two great beasts that are fighting out throughout the 20th century. Then we get to, you know, around about the 1960s, 1970s, where you might remember about a year ago we had an exhibition here of minimalism. There was a work just over there by Carl Andre, one of the great minimalist artists. And they were really one of the last isms in the 1960s and 1970s. And after that point, it was like we had postmodernism in the 1990s, the 1980s and 1990s. But after that point, it was like, nah, anything goes. Which is why we are able to sit in this gallery today, and we have on one side of the gallery the abstractionist, Brett McMahon. Where's Brett? Hey, didn't recognize you with the hat. And on the other side, we have Kit Boggs, who's down here. And these are two artists who aren't battling it out, because now we live in a world where, you know, anything goes, but, you know, we're still in equality. Now, I've met both of these artists, and I think their work is absolutely fascinating, and I think this is a brilliant show that Newcastle Art Gallery has put on. The interesting thing is, Brett is an abstractionist. Sure, look at his work here. He's working within the non-figuration. He's not working within landscapes, portraits. He's working within this sort of space of things that we haven't seen in the outside world. But I think that there's a really interesting quality to Brett's work, which is photographic. Do you know what I mean? There's something strangely photographic about, not so much the abstract sort of works over here, but some of the works, you know, when if ever you went to art school as I did about 25 years ago, you do, you know, a photogram, which is where you get a sheet of photographic paper, there's a couple of nodding heads in the ground, and, you know, you just expose, you know, you put a pair of scissors on top of it, and you just expose it, and you get this kind of outline. They have that kind of quality to them, which is really sort of interesting, I think, because they are abstractions. And at the same time, when you look at Peter's work is figurative, but Peter's work is very, very much, I don't know if you guys have had a really good look at them yet. Go look at them. They take a long time to give up what they've got. I think they're really, really fascinating works. They kind of belong, in my mind, to a tradition of surrealism or symbolism, something where, okay, just because, you know, when I'm talking about symbolism, I'm talking about someone like Edward Munch, who does The Scream, for instance. Artists who are trying to externalize what is internal. So whether that be psychological states or emotional states, and in Peter's case, it's memory. And these are memory scapes. I can't take credit for that. Sally said that to me the other day. They're memory scapes. And they very much are. And you can tell, these aren't just simply landscapes. These are places that exist in the mind as much as they exist in the outside world. I think it's fascinating how Peter's work, he actually repaints, redraws paintings that he's done over the years, and he does them from memory. So there are two, here we have, you know, these two battling factions, I suppose. What would have been 20th century art, you know, the abstract and the figuration going on within these two galleries. But I think that there is something that combines them together, and there's a kind of a, there's a sort of a mutedness, I think, about both of their books. They're both, I think, incredibly understated, and there's something really beautiful about that. I did talk with Brett about the ones over here, which were stab, 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 get it down on the canvas. It is actually. But generally, they're very, very muted. And both shows, and I think that's Newcastle, we're really fortunate to have these shows here tonight. So thank you very much.